All right, guys, it's Tim McAmis back in the showroom again tonight. We're gonna talk about some wheel tubs. We've been building carbon fiber wheel tubs. We actually had some of the first carbon tubs out on the market years and years ago before anybody else was making them. But we have a variety of sizes and diameters. And a common question for us is, what size wheel tub do I need for my application and how much clearance do I need? I thought we'd touch on that a little bit. So we've got this little sample piece here. This is a 47-inch diameter tub, so it's going to be 47 inches across the center here. This particular one is just cut off because we hang it in the showroom, but this thing is going to be wide enough to go out and meet the body of the car, and then it'll be trimmed to fit the outer perimeter of the body. These carbon tubs are really nice because they're light and they look good in the car. You can take the flat panels and finish off the interior pieces, and it looks really good when it's done. But we have 47 is our largest size. Then we'll step down to a 44, then we go to 40, and then all the way down to 34. So obviously the 34-inch stuff is gonna be for smaller tire cars, like some of the drag radial stuff, Fox Body Mustang, stuff like that, where you kind of compact in the back of the car and you're not running, maybe you're running a 275 tire or a 315 tire on it. Those smaller tubs are gonna be perfect for that because they don't consume so much room. This 47 is going to be common for us if we're going to use a 34.5 tire or a 36-inch diameter tire. These are pretty good for that because they give you plenty of extra space in the back of the car for tire growth. Now, that one question that I said was pretty common is, you know, how much clearance do I need when I set up in the chassis? So let's say we're doing a standard 34.5 tire car, a pro mod car of some configuration, and we're gonna use this 47-inch tub. So we're gonna set this up at about 39 inches from the track surface to the top of the tub. So when we put this in the chassis from the track surface, this is gonna be about 39 inches here. That'll give us enough clearance for that tire to grow and not rub on this tub. Now, obviously, for a smaller tire car or something that is going to be not an excessive amount of speed, because obviously everything factors in here. So a 34.5 tire running 210 mile an hour doesn't grow as much as a 34.5 tire running 260. So you got to take all those factors into consideration, because down track you're going to get tire growth and you're going to get body compression. So all those things can interfere with the clearance between the tub and the inside of the carbon tub. So from the tire in the tub. So, you know, I wanted to show you one thing here. So, like, you know, this will be the inside of that tub, and let's say this is the front of the car. One thing that that a lot of guys don't compensate for is the tires don't grow perfectly round and straight up. You know, they just don't get bigger as they grow. They will sling this rubber, will be more around this. So if I'm looking at this from the side of the car, you're gonna have more tire in this area right here because it's trying to get bigger, but also the momentum and the G-force on that tire is stretching that out. It's pushing it forward. It's trying to sling that rubber this way. So that tire's got a really strange shape on the track. So this area right here is where it's gonna get closer than right here. Another thing to keep in mind too is these tubs have to kind of fit up in the back window area of the car, so there's always a little bit of a cut in the corner of that back window where that back window is going to breach into that tub a little bit. It might have a little bit of an odd shape cut there, which is going to decrease the amount of clearance you have there, so you need to pay attention to how much of a notch you've got back there. So those are some things to think about when you're fitting the tub for the height and how much clearance you've got in that critical area. Now, smaller tire stuff like 275 and 315, those tires, they're stiffer and they're not gonna grow and blow out of shape like a big soft 34.5 tire would. I mean, if you take like a 34.5 or 36-inch tire off the rim, I mean, it almost folds in on itself. You know, it doesn't really have, the sidewalls don't have enough body to even hold it up. But a radial tire car, it's actually got a stiffer sidewall and a stiffer tread. It's not going to be able to sling itself out of shape nearly as much, so you can run a lot tighter clearance. For something like this 47-inch tub with a 34.5 tire, we're going to want about minimum 5.5 to 6 inches right here in that area that I was telling you about where it's going to get tight. We want to have at least that much. If you try to get that thing around 4 inches or so, it's going to touch, because remember, the tire's growing larger, the air is pushing over the back of the car and pushing down on the wing and compressing the body down onto the tire. So both pieces are moving together, trying to get in contact. So we always say, okay, if we got 5.5, 6 inches right here, we're good to go. We know it won't touch. And again, on a smaller tire car, you can run that a lot tighter and a lot closer to the tire surface than you can with a bigger tire. Look at the size you're going to run. Look at your tire size that you're going to mostly run on the car. Sometimes you may run a variety of sizes. We've got a lot of cars that are set up for both. They might run Pro Mod one weekend with a 34.5 tire, and then they might throw a 315 radial on and go run one of Donald's races. So in that case, you're going to have to put a bigger tub in to start with, so you got clearance for that big tire, and then you'll have tons of room for that smaller tire. So that's a few little hints and tips on tub size selection. Like I said, we got four sizes available. They're all in carbon, and they all have a we build in a little core liner underneath the center of the tub, not on the side, but there's a core strip that helps stiffen the tub, but it also protects the tub from the rocks that get picked up on the track, slinging up into the carbon and putting a little like a little star chip in the exterior surface. So it's got a couple of things that help. It helps with the shape of it, but it really protects from all those little pieces of trash that are on the racetrack. And you'll have to get the rubber off this stuff too. That's one thing that's different than the old style aluminum tubs, where you could get in there and scrape that rubber off. You can't really scrape on these things like you can. You can't get a putty knife. You can use like a dull face putty knife and kind of lightly scrape along there and just get the excess rubber off. But you really got to be careful not to dig into the carbon surface with that. Hope that helps you guys out. If you have any more questions, you can look on our website. We got all this stuff on there. If you still need some help, you can call one of our sales guys, and they'll be glad to talk to you about different tub sizes. Thanks for watching.